Guess what is this? It looks like this inside with a 5 cavity rock surface outside. It's called monkey pot. It's Princess Joanne. Please like my video, comment, share, and subscribe with notification bell. Thank you. Hi guys, Princess Joanne here, and today we're going to make something from this monkey pot of paradise nut. It's kind of Brazil nut, and as you can see, this is very rough. I have to do sanding, scrape off the rough surface, and I want to smooth the nut. And then inside there's a cavity inside. I wanted to take it off and then put the light in, and outside I want to put some stones and light. So let's go. So here we are. I need to remove the cavity, this thing inside, this thing, and then I will use a sandpaper and scrape off this very rough surface. I will be using this. Let's go. It's not easy to make a hole here using paper, but I believe it will be easier if I have a drilling machine. But since I don't have, let's do this way because it is doable. Okay. I need a bigger hole, so I will bring you bigger scissors. This is my solid scissor. A bigger hole. So here it is. Let's dig it out. Using my finger. Okay, number one. Clear. Okay, clear. Now it's clear. Wood varnish, hot varnish. So we will cover this place. Then when it's dry, when it's get dry, only we will do here. Okay. So this one first. And let's do it now. Okay. I advise you guys that whenever you plan to paint or do like varnish anything, do this in well ventilated area. Okay. I want the inside also to have like this. Okay, since it has like this, it can stand. Let's put it inside. Steady my darling. Okay, so let's wait until the sprite. So this is how the monkey pot looks like now after varnishing it. Okay. And the next thing we have to do is to prepare the epoxy that we want to use for this side. So I have to put it here like this to make it level and straight. Okay. I will have to use paper to, anyway, these are scratch paper. This doesn't follow any rule, you just have to, when you feel it is okay, then it's okay. When you feel that it's enough for you, then it's enough. Okay. like a bird nest inside. Okay, that's enough. Okay. That's like that. And one more. One more. Alright. Again. Okay. Okay. And after that, this is how it looks. This is how it looks now. This is a container cup. I will just have to put it here so I can have a flat surface on the side. And it's good. You can have a flat surface here. And after that, we were going to put a cellophane or clean plastic like this. And let me squeeze a bit. Squeeze in a bit. The purpose of this is we will put the epoxy mixture here. Okay. So secure this on the side. Okay. So this is where it will look like this. And now what we're going to do is to prepare the epoxy mixture. Epoxy resin A and B. We're doing it on by layering of the epoxy, so we make a little bit portion of epoxy and then we'll wait until it's a little bit hard. 90 ml of this. Okay. Okay. Ah, little bit of epoxy resin. And and 30 ml of B. Again, it's 3 is to 1, 30 A, 3, 90 ml of A, and 30 ml of B. What it makes. Then you have to pour it here. That's the purpose of the tea. You can push a bit to make it a bit flat. Okay. A little bit more. Oh, to get there. Don't poke too hard. Okay, don't poke it too hard. So it's like half already here. It's very clear. It's half.
So here are the stones or gravel that we were going to use. Here is rose quartz, benturine, amethyst, peridot, and titanium. We are going to put stone there slowly. Alright.
On one side are the rose quartz. Rose quartz on this side. Okay. Rose quartz here. And this side is titanium. Alright. Take it easy and slowly. Don't rush better.
Okay, a little bit more of this. This side. This side. Good. And I see some space in this area of my rose gold. So I have to put a bit more. And this one. Okay. And a little in this side. One more on this side. Okay. So we will have to wait until this gets dry and we will proceed on. So here it is now. You can see the crystal clear and it's hard. So we have to take this off. Oh, this is it. And take out all the things that we put here. Okay. We have to remove all these things. The paper. The paper. And this will be, we need to take off the plastic. Okay. It's like a candy. It's like a candy. Ooh. Pull the plastic away. It's like this. So it goes like this here. Oh my god. It will be like that. So now we're going to make a base for our monkey pot. And I am using this from a frozen food as a base mold. And we will put an epoxy mixture here and then we will put this thing. And to sum it up, I will also be using some twigs and seeds. Seeds is actually baby's finger seed. So we need to put plastic here. So it will be easy to remove later. Okay. It will be like that. And stand by. Let's stand by this one and we will work on our mixture. So again, 3:1, 3 part of A and 1 part of this. I will be using 3 cup of this and 1 cup of this. So 3 cup of the A, cup of A. Okay. And 1 cup of this B. 3:1 ratio. That's it. So let's do this until it's still like nothing else. While I'm mixing it, I want to put some of blue. It's a blue glitter, okay. It's okay now. So back to our tray, to our mold. We just have to put a bit of mixture first. And we can put some of the seeds now. The twigs. And put the twigs here. I want to finish all this. Finish all the twigs here. Okay. That's it. I leave a empty space here, so when we put the monkey pot, we have enough space. So set this aside for a while, and we'll work on for another mixture. Another mixture. So we use the same. I think we need a more bigger quantity. We'll make 6 of this. Okay. So it's done now.
need to take everything out of mold and just splash it or pour it in and push the pin. Okay. Alright. That will be the piece. And we can press in our monkey pot inside to secure the place for it. So this will be for this way. Set it in the center and a little bit like that. We will wait until the stains get dry. While we are waiting for our base to get dry, we will work on the lips of this monkey pot. We will put a little bit of remaining silicone there. Okay. Right. So that while we're waiting, use this one, my favorite of all. This fingers is so nice. I think I better use this also. Just to start it. Okay, let's get back again later. Our base is now dry, so let's take it out. Yeah, it's can easily remove. Oh, there's a mark left here. So this will be the sign that this is the bottom. This is how it is. Okay. This is how it is. Let's remove the plastic. This is how it is. Bluish base. With twigs and opera seed inside. That is how it is. So this is the back and this is the front. And this is the bottom. So we can put it like that. It's like that. Okay. And we need to remove some of the unwanted things like this here. Just use a scissor to cut it up. Okay, how do you like this? This thing itself is very artistic. Pump that I will put it inside. So I am improvising this. And this is actually from the bottle. And I have to put it there like that. The bunch of plastic again. Okay, take this out first. I'll put the plastic again so I can put the slime in inside this so we can have the space for the lamp. We'll put my lamp. Okay. That will be fine. I think so. Like that. Okay. I better use a slime. Point. I will pour out slime there. This is a long overdue slime. So be careful. Put on the side here. So we can make a hollow. This will be the hollow. And here is the epoxy. So let's put this aside for a while. Again, three parts of A and one part of B. Just put the mixture here. Mix it up until it is pure. Now it is done. We can pour it out. I think this is enough. We can pour it out on the side of our project. If you want to put something also here, also can. I still have a bit of opera seed here. This is. I have some mango seed here, baby mango seed, that I can put also. Oh yeah, this side is a bit crowded. Just to make the thing more secure and steady. And a little more. Okay. Okay, the inside will look like this. Alright.
So, our epoxy is hard now. We need to take this out. The slime first. We need a pliers to remove it. Check it out, baby. Right away, this messy slimy. But it's alright, there's still have a stuck plastic inside, and it's alright with this slime, it can be removed easily. So we have to take off that remain inside, and yeah, just grab it with plier. Just remove what we can remove, and it's for the halo to put on our lamp. This is how it looks like inside. It's quite clear and cute.
Okay, so our last step. Now we are going to spray with this. Okay, it's a clear paint. Spray paint. So
we'll spray it. Yep, here. And here in this side, take it slowly, just roll a twist the pot so we can cover all the surface. And yeah, you can do it this way and you can do it other way. So here it is, and we will wait until this gets dry if needs second layer of coating. So okay, stand by. Here it is now. Yeah, it's so nice. I just like to maintain the natural looks of the pot. And so next, we're fixing up our light. This is a lamp that I bought in Shopee. Thank you, Shopee. We have to knot it out like this so it will not go through. I have to remove this cover for a while so it can pass through the hole that I make using my scissor. Okay, slowly pull the cord and insert in the bottom side. It's like this. Get in, get out. All right so close it back like this and set the lamp inside in the hollow that we made. Alright, so that will be fixed in and stapled inside, like this. And we have to set our lamp, night lamp, put on the base, and yes, set it in. And our magical crystal clear cover with special natural stone. Just fix it in and put on the cord. It can use also with the power bank. All right on it on. This is how it looks with the lights on and with the dark. It looks like a moon. It's so nice. It's so pretty. This is it. How would you like it?
Thank you for watching my video. This is our finished product. It's called Monkey Pot Night Lamp. It is good for the side table, and it's like this. This will goes to my mom as a present. I hope she like it. How would you like it too? Please don't forget to comment down your thought about this video, and don't forget to subscribe, like, and share my video. Thank you so much for your support. Love you guys, and get blessed.
I just want to share with you guys how the monkey pot tree looks like here. It's still young, yet still have a fruit also. And it's so tall, it's so nice, and it's so awesome.